and your oil pump will end up ramping because most of these are on a VFD, not all of them, but most of them. Time is finally here, guys. We have been talking about doing shaft seal for quite some time. If you're not familiar with it, I recently changed this seal out on a York YK, and I have finally got my studio, got everything set up in such a way to where I'm actually ready to do this video. So hope you enjoy it. We're going to get into the actual nitty gritties of this thing. It is quite super heavy. So up front, this is a pretty easy repair to do overall when it comes to centrifugals. I could really suggest anybody that's looking to start learning how to do centrifugal type work or anything of that nature, this would be a really good repair to kind of cut your teeth on or to get some guidance with. To do this repair, you are going to have to do a full recovery. You won't need to pull the oil out of the system. It will drain on its own. But this will also allow you to practice doing vacuum and recovery on a centrifugal system. If you ever do one of these, something I do highly suggest is make sure you do the oil filter and the filter dryer as well when you do this repair. Those are all critical parts of the system. Again, you're completely taking the system down to make this repair. What I want to show you today is kind of just some of the inner workings of this. So what you're looking at is this is the side of the seal that you would be seeing if you were to open up the decoupler housing and see inside of the compressor, where you've got the compressor on one side and the motor on the other, and then there's literally a coupling in between. So the motor on these is not in the refrigerant stream like it is on a lot of centrifugals. So that's something to keep in mind as you're working on this. Now over here I have a 1/8, a 5/32, and a 3/16, and I'll explain more of these. But whenever you go to do this repair, so this ring is the actual ring that seats down against the shaft, and each of these little Allen heads here, and there's six of them in total. The older ones had four, but the new ones have a six arrangement. These all need to be tightened down nice and even with your new one. So taking it apart, it's not that big a deal. They have these little clamps, and so how these work is you just pop these off, and then they kind of sit over here to the side. So when you first open it up on a system that's in operation, you're going to see that these little clamps are sitting off to the side over here. If you do not see them in place like this, I do recommend you definitely want to find them. There is a series of different mechanisms and springs in here, and really these are really beneficial in helping you keep alignment on there. One really critical tip, and it's going to help you save this O-ring back here, especially whenever you're sliding onto the shaft, you want to make sure that the keyway that's in the shaft, you don't let it rub on any of this interior, specifically that O-ring in there. What that can do is that can literally create little cut slits if the walls of the keyway on the shaft are able to rub against that. Okay, at this point, we've got the keepers pulled back. We're going to go ahead and flip it over. And you've got a couple of O-rings here. This is the main O-ring that seals this housing to the main body. They've had a couple of different versions of these seals over time. What I want to point out with this specific one is this is kind of just a one body style. On some of the older ones, you did have a multiple piece breakdown, but on the really old ones, you actually just had, it's almost like a flat plate. It wasn't even this intricate, and that plate just slid over the shaft, and it had some seals and stuff in it to obviously seal the shaft and the O-ring and whatnot, but it was a lot simpler design. This one has gotten a lot more complicated. We've got these four bolts here on the back side. This is the side that sits in the refrigerant stream. You've got some oil ports and things in here. And then we've got a 3/16 Allen we're going to bust these open with. This is your rear housing. At this point, it's just a hunk of metal. So we'll set this off to the side. The this is your outer seal housing. You see there's a series of O-rings in here as well. And this is where your main seal assembly slides into. Now, with the way they designed these today, I'm doing this breakdown because I'm just trying to show you what is in here. In reality, you don't have to do this in the field anymore. What you'll end up buying, and if you go watch the video where I actually did this repair, you buy this entire housing as one kit. And that's the way you want to do it. Trust me. There's some mechanical seals in here that you do not want to try to do this in the field if you don't absolutely have to. It is worth purchasing the complete assembly from the factory and doing it that way. First, your inner mechanical seal. Now, this is an actual machined surface, and this is what you have to be really careful with when you're working on this, is you cannot make physical contact with this, and this is a big reason why I really suggest you do the kit instead of trying to do this yourself, because this seal right here actually makes a mechanical, like they ran this through a machine shop and machined these surfaces to be perfectly even and flush with one another. And something as little as your oil getting on this, like if you're handling this out in the field, you have to do something like this in order to not make physical contact with it. You have to be extremely careful. This is the inside where the refrigerant stream is, and it's making contact, and this whole assembly is spinning like so. There's one. They've got these tiny little Allens, which are held in by a 3/32, and this is the shaft collar itself. So this is the part that actually mounts with the shaft and is rotating. It does rotate with this main assembly. So this is your springs that are shifting. Any one of these rings can start to get worn over time and start to cause a leak. These machine surfaces are probably the most sensitive, in my opinion, to have a leaking issue. These O-rings tend to do pretty good overall, but this inner O-ring gets really worn. This outer O-ring can get really worn. This one doesn't stay lubed with the oil like most of these others do. These others will have a little bit of an oil drain or trickle hit them. And you can actually see you have what they call the flush point or port here. And then the drain is down here, so it's putting oil in through it, and then it's draining out as it has a little bit of oil seepage, which is completely normal for these. The little canister on the bottom of the D housing, you're allowed to fill by the book as long as you're not filling that up. Heck, I said it wrong last time. I think it was once every 14 days, according to the factory, you're doing okay. My opinion is if you're getting to the point where you're filling that housing up once every couple of months, you need to go ahead and start to plan to do a seal. Most of my YK chillers or even my YTs, I don't have issues with the shaft seals leaking at any given time. Like I don't have to do that many of them because, well, we take really good care of them up front. We keep them out of surge conditions so they don't have a lot of shaft wear. We make sure that the motor alignment is good. And that's probably the biggest thing that really hurts these the most. And it's not very easy getting a proper alignment on the motor to the compressor shaft on these. But if that motor is not aligned properly, that's going to put the most wear and tear on this shaft. It's really important anytime you're working on any of this stuff that you use the factory seal lube and the moly coat. So the moly coat is going to do a lot to really help you. You can use some of the compressor oil, put it around the shaft to help make this slide on easier. You want to use some moly coat on the O-rings here and on this one inside as you're sliding it all together. In New Freedom, Pennsylvania, they do a overhaul class or a teardown class. It's a week-long course you can take through Johnson Controls. And they will certify you in this and give you all the documentation, everything that you need. Before you ask, I do have to say that Documentation like this is extremely expensive, and my company does not like me to pass those things out. If you're not comfortable, familiar, if you've never done this before, you need somebody to do this with you and go through it the first time to kind of help show you through it. You can see right there, there's a little bit of buildup corrosion. Something happened right there. This one was actually leaking pretty significantly. Whenever we decided to do the shaft seal on it, it was filling up about once a month. Now, we started telling them once it got to where once every 2 to 3 months, we said, hey, this shaft seal is significantly getting worse. You really need to look at changing this very soon. In the time it took for us to start recommending that, get the quotes together, get all the documentation to them, it had escalated to the point to where they were actually able to fill that bottle up once a month, which is pretty significant. So I know, yes, says per the factory, they say, yeah, you can run all the way up to, you know, you fill it up every 2 weeks. My issue with that is once you push these machines to set that kind of extreme on repair, you're going to start to see the symptoms of a bad seal. So when these seals go bad, the symptoms that they create is you can't maintain oil pressure, and your oil pump will end up ramping because most of these are on a VFD, not all of them, but most of them, this particular one was. So that VFD on that pump starts to ramp up, you know, and normally it can run, you know, mid 30s, maybe 40 hertz and keep up just fine. But once these seals start to get very leaky and that bottle starts to fill up, by the time you're hitting the point where the factory says, hey, you need to change it, you're going to start having issues with being able to maintain oil pressure to begin with. That's why I highly suggest going ahead and preemptively doing this, because if it's functioning properly and the alignment on the motor and all that's good anyway, you'll never have to do this. You know, this isn't, well, let me rephrase that. Not that you'll never have to do this. You'll be able to get very extended lengths of time between having to do them. I'm talking, you know, I've got machines go 10 years and never need a shaft seal, okay? It's all about how well you take care of the machine, how good your motor alignment is. You know, it's a heart sink moment when you open up the dehousing on the compressor and what's inside waiting for you is literally a little bit of standing oil inside of there because that bottle had filled up to the point where it couldn't hold anymore. Things to have when you go to buy this is, again, you want to make sure you've got that Molly coat. You want to make sure you've got extra lube. You want to make sure you've got extra oil so that way you can use some of the oil to lubricate things. They also make a seal lube that I highly recommend. It's kind of a greasy substance, does really well for the O-rings and stuff. The Molly coat helps seat the surfaces together as well. Hope you enjoyed it, guys. Appreciate it. MTT, take care of your family. Take care of your spouse. They really need you. Hope you like kind of the new studio setup, and tell me what you think about it. You know, do you like this top-down view thing? Does it look interesting to you? You know, did you enjoy this video? Let me know. I am working on a series of other things. I am trying to also build out our website more. I'll continue to keep you updated as I get those things developed and put together. And I'll see you.